I think that to start off with is the first premise, the first assumption that we need to make is that we are a biological organism. We're biological. And that biology, our structure and the function of our nervous system and our body contribute to how we perceive the world and how we react and interact with others. So it becomes a substrate of our understanding of our social behavior and our psychological experiences, not a correlate. I think too much of the integration between neuroscience and psychotherapy has been looking for correlates or parallels. And if we think more in terms of emergent properties that are built on our underlying neurophysiology, I think intuitively it's going to be much more comfortable for the clinician, and the scientist can see the bridge more easily. In general, when you ask neuroscientists to contribute to the world of psychotherapy, they'll give you slides of neuroanatomy, slides of physiology, and then slides of imaging, and then some correlates of various states, and then they'll go home. And then the clinicians will say, well, very interesting. I took a lot of notes, but how does that relate to my clinical practice? And so the issue really is if we start understanding that physiological state, how we basically feel and how our body contributes to how we feel. This is an example is if we have a stomach ache, the afferents or the sensory pathways from our gut are being transmitted up to our brain and influence the way that we react to others. So in a sense, you'll start finding in your clinical populations lots of people with gastrointestinal problems. And it's not like it's a correlate. It's in part of the process that is leading to their psychological experiences and their difficulty in being socially connected with others. And so we start seeing these very, very primary biological processes. But in general, neuroscience has been less interested in those types of questions and much more interested in brain processes without realizing or integrating the fact that the brain is not only regulating processes in the brain and perhaps thoughts and ideas, but it has a major job. It's regulating what's going on in our body.